Sometimes we're not sure about the accuracy of the monitors that we're using to color grade. In these cases, we need to use scopes. To access scopes here, just right-click on the monitor and go to Show Scopes. We're presented with the four types of scopes available in DaVinci. We have the waveform, the RGB parade, histogram, and victroscope. We are going to be discussing every one of these scopes individually. Let's start with the waveform. I'm going to hide the other scopes through coming here and just choosing one up. Now I have only the waveform. If I wanted to change the scope that is being displayed now, I have to go here and choose parade, victroscope, or histogram. Let's keep the waveform now. I can resize the scope through clicking on the bottom right and dragging. Let's lay the scope here. Now, you'll notice that this scope have horizontal lines. The horizontal line on the bottom represents black. The line on the top represents white. And this reading here represents the image. So this is our image represented on the waveform. So, the first thing that we will notice is that our darkest point in the image, which happens to be here, is not black. This means that our image lacks contrast at the moment. So, I'll go to primaries and bring the lift down. Now you can notice contrast here. Let's look at the original image and this one. You will also notice that our brightest point in the image is not white. We have to go to gain and increase the gain. So, now, our darkest point is black and our brightest point is white. And of course, to brighten the image without affecting the darkest or the brightest point in the image, we go to gamma and we increase the gamma. Take a look at the original image and the new image. Notice the contrast difference. Now let's reset this and go back to RGB parade. This is the RGB parade, which is the same as the histogram, only divided into the three channels. So we have the histogram of the red channel, the histogram of the green, and the blue. This is very beneficial when we want to balance a shot. You'll notice here that I have on the lift controls, I have the overall lift control, and I have the lift control for red, green, and blue. And I also have the channel controls for gamma, and the channel controls for gain. The first thing we'll notice here is that the blue channel is a bit off than the other channels. So, instead of raising the gain of the entire image, what we will do is that we will increase the gain of the blue channel. So, let's go to the blue channel and increase the gain in the blue channel a bit. Notice how it's balancing with the other channels? Now, let's add a new node and balance the entire image. I'll take the lift down and increase the gain up, and I'll adjust the gamma. Let's reset this and go to the histogram. Notice that the histogram is laid horizontally. So, the darkest point in the image is on the left side, and the brightest point of the image is on the right side, and this is absolute black and this is absolute white. So again, let's balance this shot here. The blue channel is a bit off. So, let's increase the blue channels. In this case, when I increase it, it will go to the right. So, let me increase the blue channel. And again, I'll add a new nod. And just bring the darkest point in the image towards black. And I'll bring the brightest point in the image towards white. And I'll adjust the gamma again. So, let's reset this again and go to victroscope. Now, the victroscope is a bit different. It does not represent brightness, it represents color. Now, in the victroscope, we have six colors represented. This is red, green, blue, cyan, magenta, and yellow. Notice that when I increase the saturation, okay, how the color value will increase. Let me add a new node and increase the saturation again. Add a new node and increase the saturation even more. Usually, your color values should not exceed the line between these points. So I'm just going to dial this down a bit. Notice that these are exactly the same layout of the color wheel. So if I come to the color wheel, I have the red on the top, red, green, green, blue, blue, and of course cyan, magenta, and yellow. cyan, magenta, and yellow. Now, this means that whatever I do to the color wheel will be represented in the Victroscope. And these were scopes.